the time.
All the time.
God is good.
For such a time as this, for such a time as this, we've been summoned here by God. For such a time as this, we will.
Good morning. I'm short. our cordless mic was not working this morning, so I'm going to be sharing a mic with Dave. Welcome to our worship. There's a bit of chaos this morning. I don't ever think of everything like everyone's going to be sitting in the sun, hot sun. I didn't think it would be that hot. So sorry about that. We'll do better next time. But welcome to our first in our new schedule, where we will be having a combined worship on the first Sunday of the month, and then we will return to our 8:30 and 10:30 worship styles the following Sunday, and the rest of the week, rest of the month. Thank you to the musicians who have collaborated for this worship. Roughly, the first part of the worship will be more like the 8:30 service, and the last part more like the 10:30. I think that's all I need to say now. Oh, I say I need to make announcements, so I guess I'll do that now before we do our praise song. This is our first time also in live streaming. Hopefully it's working. Wave to those. I don't know where the camera's focused, but it's on me, on us, okay. Wave to those who are worshiping live with us via their computers or other devices. And this will be recorded, and then we will post it so that it can be watched later on, too. We need people to be able to run the camera, to do the live streaming. Dave can't do it every Sunday. When he is doing the praise band, he's on the opposite side of the sanctuary of where the equipment's going to be. So please let me know if you're willing to help with that. It's not that hard, right, Dave? It should be. He'll tell you how to do it. Let us know if you can do that. I also want to say that Adult Sunday School is meeting today in person following the worship about a little after 10, I guess. Our office schedules are moving more towards normal. Misty is planning to be in the office this week, beginning this week, Monday through Thursday. As she has been in the past, 9 till 2. And do not leave before you buy something at the summer sale. This is to put a little fun in our June, and also to help support our weekly, monthly budget. We've done a good job of getting out of debt with our line of credit, but we need to keep up our general budget so that we don't have to do that again. So I saw some plants, I saw some goodies go over there, some crafts. Pick something up and pay for it before you leave. Also, last week I mentioned as an aside that I had 28 pots of flowers. And then somebody said, well, could you give a tour I don't know if I'll be able, but if you want to, after church or after Sunday school, you can come over. Whether one of us is there or not, you can come look at our flowers. I was gone for 2 days, two nights this week, and Dave texted me that there are not 28 or 29 pots. There are 30 pots.
By
his count. And when you go to water every night, that takes a little while. Anyway, and you can look at my garden too if you want. I did weed it once this year. All right, let's sing. Our first song is, what is our first song? You have song sheets there. My Hope Is Built. And let us remember that our hope is built on Jesus Christ. Let us sing to praise to God. Let us glorify God's name.
Thank you.
The Spirit can move us, direct us. Let us sing when the Spirit says sing.
Let us stand when Paul says stand. This is like the early service. You don't have to stand, but Kathy Miller's doing it. And
I'm gonna sing when the Spirit says sing. I'm gonna sing when the Spirit says sing. I'm gonna sing when the Spirit says sing. And obey the Spirit of the Lord. I'm gonna pray when the Spirit says pray. I'm gonna pray.
Sometimes life can be difficult and we don't know the way, but if we walk by faith, God will show us.
2, 3, 4.
Each step.
I trust in you. Walk by faith, I put my trust in you. I put my trust in you. I put my trust in you. I put my trust in you.
From country to rock and roll. Alrighty. You can be seated. You can, I know you've already greeted one another, but wave to each other. If you want to get up, you can, but hello, our Christian family, our household of faith.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the
as He taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. If you are able, you may stand if you would like to and sing together, "This is My Father's World." Scripture reading today is from Mark chapter 3, verses 20 through 27 and 31 through 35. And the crowd came together so that they could not even eat. When his family heard it, they went out to restrain him, for people were saying, "He has gone out of his mind." And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, "He has Beelzebul, and by the ruler of the demons, he casts out demons." And he called them to him and spoke to them in parables. How can Satan cast out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand, but his end has come. But no one can enter a strong man's house and plunder his property without first tying up the strong man. Then indeed the house can be plundered. Then his mother and his brothers came, and standing outside, they sent to him and called him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they said to him, "Your mother and your brothers and sisters are outside asking for you." And he replied, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" And looking at those who sat around him, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother." Weave us together. Weave us together in unity and love. Weave us together. Weave us together in love. That is a song that I learned many years ago. I think it was published in the 1970s. It seems that it describes some of my upbringing as well as my experience in early ministry. For I was all about trying to promote and create unity. For example, I was on the conference council on ecumenical and interreligious concerns for a while. Throughout my career as a United Methodist pastor, I've been at two churches, two appointments, where there was shared ministry with the Presbyterian Church. And I used to faithfully, every January, celebrate the week of prayer for Christian unity. And I think with those celebrations and that emphasis goes with my commitment to inclusiveness. One of the verses of the song, Weave Us Together, says, "We are many textures, we are many colors, each one different from the other. But we are entwined with one another in one great tapestry." That vision of unity has been blurred for me, and my enthusiasm waned since, partly because of some negative experiences with working with cooperative parishes that weren't quite so cooperative, and some other things. But it's made me wonder if unity is all it is cracked up to be. Although there has been a lot of ecumenical cooperation throughout the years between denominations, the divisiveness has increased within our churches, within our denominations, and in our country. The sad part is how we have easily demonized those with different opinions. We have done this in our neighborhoods, in the political arena, and yes, the church. Well, if we look at today's scripture, Jesus was demonized by people also. It's interesting how he was at one time popular, but also for some people, he easily turned in people's minds from different to insane to demonic. Even Jesus' family thought he was crazy, and they tried to subdue him. When you think about it, he was crazy according to the standards of society. For the principles of the kingdom of God turned those standards upside down. The needs of the weak are attended to rather than the needs of the strong. Those of low cultural status are lifted up. And in the upside down kingdom, all people, no matter what ethnic group, religion, age, or gender, are eligible for adoption in the household of Christ. Well, there were many trying to figure out who Jesus was and why he said and did what he did. For they observed him in his action, in his healings and teachings. The scribes thought that Jesus was ruled by Satan and needed to have demons exorcised from him. Those of faith believed that he acted like he did because God ruled him. So there was a difference of opinion and perspective. He is God in the flesh. And so we believe that God ruled him. There's some other evidence in our stories of scripture where people of faith were and the followers of Jesus were suspect. On the day of Pentecost, it was thought that the disciples were filled with new wine. In other words, drunk. Peter corrected the crowd by saying that they were instead filled with the Holy Spirit. And the Spirit is what made people do these strange yet wonderful, miraculous things. The Holy Spirit birthed the church family. And our church family is increased by the Spirit. We are led by the Spirit unless we let evil lead us instead. So in this parable in Mark 3, Jesus is talking about conflict between Satan and the Holy Spirit, or you might say between good and evil. And if they were accusing him of being Satan, it doesn't make any sense, and wanting to cast Satan out of him, because Satan cannot cast out Satan. And if he cast himself out, he would have no more influence. Obviously, it would not be in Satan's best interests to do that. Jesus, however, has our interests, not his, in mind. If Jesus were concerned only for himself, he would have quit preaching, teaching, and healing early on. It cost him dearly. In fact, it cost him his life. If we let Jesus be the head of our family, our household of God, if we allow Jesus to be the head of the church, then there will be no room for Satan. This is the kind of unity I think we need for our church. The unity that is devotion and service to Christ. And anyone who does the will of God is welcome in Christ's church. Loyalty to the mission and to the call of Christ outweighs loyalty to family. Loyalty to the mission and call of Christ is more important than unity. It is faith that unites us. And the church, the household of faith or the household of God, is only strong when it is following the call of Christ. In Jesus' vision of the fulfillment of the kingdom of God, there will be shalom, peace, unity and wholeness. Perhaps that is what we should be praying for and leaning into. Shalom.
It includes unity. And reflecting on my experience with my quest for unity, perhaps maybe where I went wrong is that I wasn't considering Christ's faithfulness to Christ's ideals, but I was making unity the focus instead. And I'm not saying that Christ disapproves of unity. No, Jesus prayed that we would be united and that we would be one in Him. But unity should not be the focus, not the end all. But the will of God should be. When we focus on unity, example, separate from justice, we are not giving ourselves to the work of Christ. Another example would be that the quest for unity could silence some people with important thoughts or ideas for fear of upsetting the peace. People would give up their convictions and settle to be a part of a church or a denomination, but not feel fully a part of it. I want God to weave us together in unity and love. I want a beautiful tapestry of us all. But I don't want us loosely held together so that it only looks like unity. If we are haphazardly woven together, then our household will not be stable. We won't be able to be our own true selves, and our collective witness to the reconciling love of Christ will be weak. Let us look forward to the time and place where kingdoms and households are united, not divided. I invite you to join me into living to growing into this kingdom of God that is ushered in, and to the household into which we are nurtured and sent out in love. Our first weaving may have holes in it. It may have loose strands or puckers. The colors might not be quite right. But over time, we can become a beautiful tapestry. Indeed, weave, weave, weave us together, together in love. Let us consider our gifts to God. Of course, you can send your gifts in, but this time we remember what God has given to us and do that in celebration.
Let us pray. Oh God, we thank you indeed for all of the gifts of creation and all the gifts that you have poured upon us by the power of your Spirit. Help us to use these gifts to glorify you and to serve others in Christ's name. Amen. Our last hymn is Sent Forth by God's Blessing. You'll find the words on your song sheet. Jesus Christ, may your Holy Spirit be with you, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.